Boom. Hey, internets. Great question. Great conversation. We're talking about t-shirt production, and I'm talking about typical screen printing production for a shirt. I'm talking transfers and a lot of different ways to get to the end result. But for this video, I'm talking about sizing up artwork for screen printed t-shirts and or blanks. And so the conversation for this actually came out of a quality control situation or conversation about getting shirts done with a screen printing shop. But for this video here, this is one direction where I led, where I want to point this out and give a whole separate video to it. For quality control, also for the development, right, in the design cycle of creating your products, right? Whether that's t-shirts, hats, cut and sew, any of that. All of it has a cycle where it's doing design. And then when you're producing, right? So when you're getting your samples back. Now, before you send your artwork to the printer, you want to make sure you have everything called out in your tech packs in terms of the artwork, the sizing, the colors, if you need to, and placement. And so how do you do that? How do you do that in a very scientific way on the tech pack is you print out the design and literally place it on a physical t-shirt so that you can see what it looks like, okay? And we've been doing this for decades in art departments all around the world, not just the US, but even in the first skate company that I worked for in 2000, we had a good color printer. We would cut it out, and then if it was placed on a black shirt or let's say a Kelly green shirt, doesn't matter. We would put that background and sort of try to color match it. You don't want to go crazy with that, but that's why white and black are very easy, right? So you put the artwork on that and then have the border around that artwork be that self color. So if it's black or Kelly green, then the artwork would be printed out with that as the background. Now, we wouldn't do the whole sheet like that because as you know, it wastes a lot of ink. Let's say you have a black background to some artwork, that's a lot of black ink. So we just have it around the edges. And so you just cut it out, but you do the actual size. So if you have to tape together a couple 8.5 by 11s, you tape those together and you're just getting a rough look of what the actual semi-final or maybe final artwork looks like on the shirt and where you're gonna put it. And when designers are pitching designs to me, if I'm running an art department, this is obviously something we'll do. I've done and seen so many t-shirts and owned a high volume screen printing shop for over 3 years where I know what that's gonna look like. But there are a few cases now where I still say, you know what, can you cut that out and comp it on a shirt so we can see what that looks like so we can finalize that placement and kind of, you know, we'll kind of go back and forth over those details. But that's how you do it. That's how we do it in the industry. You can do it easily at home as well. Just to get a preview of what that looks like. And you can do this with everything, with hats, any kind of artwork you're doing on a cut and sew garment as well. We use this all the time. I'll use it with actual pockets if I'm working with a different kind of pocket. But yeah, print it out, cut it out, superimpose it onto the garment you're actually going to use, and you'll get a very much good idea of that visual and what that's going to look like. Hope that helps. If you want ridiculous detail about producing hats and shirt from blanks, this is like the foundational course for launching a clothing line. Check out my course for starting with tees and hats. It's going to be linked down below. If you had any other questions, you could drop them all down below because I read all the comments, or you could just hit me at this number here. It gets my iPhone every time. See you guys on the next one. Bye.